Hi everyone, and welcome to AS RoBo. In today's video, we're building a smart dustbin with waste segregation using image classification. I'll show you step by step how to collect images, use edge impulse, and program the ESP32 CAM to sort waste into separate compartments automatically. Make sure to watch till the end for all the details. For this project, you will need an Arduino Uno, an I2C OLED display, a servo motor, an ESP32 CAM module, a breadboard, and some jumper wires. This is the circuit diagram to upload the code to the ESP32 using Arduino Uno. The link to download the circuit diagram is given in the description. First, create a dustbin with two compartments using cardboard, one for electronic waste and another for dry waste. Attach a servo motor to the dustbin and connect the lid of the dustbin to the servo motor. Then, make a stand to mount the all components. Attach the Arduino Uno, ESP32, and breadboard to the stand. Make the connections between the ESP32 and Arduino Uno using jumper wires as per the circuit diagram. The link to the circuit diagram is provided in the description. First, connect the 5-volt and ground pins of ESP32 to the corresponding 5-volt and ground pins of the Arduino Uno. Then, connect the RX pin to RX and the TX pin to TX. Ensure the reset pin of the Arduino Uno is connected to its ground pin, and the IO0 pin of the ESP32 is connected to its ground pin. After making all the connections, verify them with the circuit diagram. Then connect the Arduino Uno to a laptop and open the Arduino IDE. First, collect images of objects using the ESP32 CAM module to create a dataset. In the Arduino IDE, go to File, then Examples. Search for Eloquent ESP32 CAM and select Collect Images for Edge Impulse. Ensure all necessary libraries are installed. Library names are provided in the description. Enter your Wi-Fi name and password in the code. And change the module type to AI Thinker. Select the AI Thinker, ESP32. And the appropriate port. Click the Upload button. It may take a few minutes to compile and upload. Do not disconnect the Arduino Uno during this process. Once the code is uploaded, open the serial monitor. Remove the IO0 and ground pin connection and press its reset button. An image collection server link will appear in the serial monitor. Copy this IP address, paste it into a browser, and the image collection page will open. Adjust the dustbin position to fit within the camera frame. We are going to take images of objects from different angles to create a dataset. First, we will create a dataset of the battery. Place it on the lid of the dustbin. Click the Start Collecting button and take 3 to 5 images before clicking the Stop button. Change the angle of the battery and repeat this process until you have approximately 20 images. You can collect up to 40 or 50 images. Download the dataset by clicking Download and label it as Battery. Automatically, zip file will be downloaded. Next, clear the collection and repeat the process to create dataset of paper. Click the Download button, saving the dataset as paper. Open Edge Impulse. If you are using it for the first time, create an account on the site and then log in. Click on Create New Project. Give a name to the project click on Create New Project. Before adding the datasets to the site, extract the zip files. We have created datasets for two objects, battery and paper. This is the dataset of all collected battery images. Now extract the other file. This is the dataset of all collected images of paper. Now open Edge Impulse and click on Add Existing Data, then Upload Data. Click Select a folder. Choose the extracted file of battery. And click Upload. Then enter the label name as battery. And click the Upload Data button. Click Yes. Now choose the other file of paper and click Upload. And click the Upload Data button. So this is the combined data of both battery and paper. There are a total of 35 items present in the dataset. We need to give labels to all 35 items. Click on Labeling Queue. Select Track Objects Between Frames. Now move the cursor on the image, select the battery and drag like this. Then give the label name, Battery. Click on Save Label. Make sure that the frame is correctly placed for the next image. Similarly, do this for all images. When we get the paper, select the proper frame and change the label name to paper. The color of the frame also changes. Similarly, do it for the remaining images. Now click on Create Impulse, then click Save. Keep all the options as default. Click on Add a Processing Block and add an Image Processing Block. Then click on Add a Learning Block and add an Object Detection Learning Block. Here you can see two output features, battery and paper. Then click on Save Impulse. Now click on Image. Change the color depth to grayscale and click Save Parameters. Then click on Generate Features. It will take some time to generate features. Once it is done, you can see a map showing how each object is different from the other. Here we can see that batteries are far away from papers. Two clusters are formed with different colors. Now click on Object Detection. Keep the number of training cycles to 60. Change the learning rate to 0.01. Keep all other options as default and click on Save and Train. It will take 2 to 10 minutes based on the number of images, training cycles, and learning rate you have put. Now the model has finished training. This is the result of our model. The model is able to identify both the battery and the paper with 100% accuracy. This is a very good score. Scores between 90 and 100 are considered very good. Now we need to deploy the model. Click on Deployment. Select Arduino Library. Then click on Change Target. Select ESPi for ESP32. And click on Save. Then click on Build. A zip file containing all libraries and code will be downloaded. Now we need to add this zip file to the Arduino IDE. Open the Arduino IDE, click on Sketch, then Include Library, and then Add Zip Library. Select the downloaded zip file and add it. Once the library is successfully installed, click on File, then Examples, then search for the library name. And click on ESP32, then ESP32 Camera. Now this code is set for ESPi by default, so remove it and enable AI Thinker, which will work for the ESP32 CAM module. The link to the code is given in the description. Now select the board as AI Thinker ESP32 CAM. This code, generated by Edge Impulse, is for object detection only. We need additional code to control the servo motor and OLED display. This is the updated code. Install the necessary libraries for the OLED display and the servo motor. The names of all required libraries are given in the description. The updated code link is also given in the description. Now make the connection of the ESP32 with the Arduino Uno as per the circuit diagram. Connect the Arduino Uno to the laptop and select the proper port. Click the upload button. It will take more than 5 minutes to compile and upload the code. After uploading is complete, remove the IO0 and ground pins of the ESP32 CAM. Open the serial monitor. Click the reset button of the ESP32. Now we can see that we are able to detect the objects. Connect the servo motor and the OLED display to the ESP32 as per the circuit diagram. The link to the circuit diagram is given in the description. Connect the 5-volt and ground pins of the ESP32 to the breadboard. Connect the 5-volt and ground pins of the Arduino to the breadboard. Connect the 5-volt and ground pins of the servo motor to the breadboard. Connect the PWM pin of the servo to pin 12 of the ESP32 CAM module. Connect the 5-volt and ground pins of the OLED display to the breadboard. Connect the SDA and SCL pins of the OLED display to pins 15 and 14 of the ESP32, respectively. Now give power to the Arduino Uno. Let us see the working of the project. Here you can see that the ESP32 CAM module is able to detect the battery and paper easily with good accuracy, and the servo motor moves the lid accordingly. The OLED display shows all relevant information. That's all for this project. Don't forget to like this video and subscribe to the channel for more exciting projects. Thank you for watching.